In this video, I'll show you how you can download, install, and use the Tor browser in 2020. By the end of the video, you'll be able to use the Tor browser to browse the normal internet as well as the deep web. My name is Lafara from NKT Studios. Let's get into it. I'm going to start off by one of the most frequently asked questions. Is installing Tor illegal? Just using Tor to browse the internet is not illegal. The download is free and hiding your IP address and browsing history is not in and of itself illegal. However, many of those that use Tor use it specifically for anonymity because they are doing something questionable or possibly illegal. But you don't have to be a hacker, criminal, or be up to no good to want to be anonymous online. Maybe you simply don't want companies tracking you and you value your privacy. There are a couple of secure privacy-focused browsers that you can use such as Brave, but in this video we'll be talking about the Tor browser. The name Tor comes from the acronym of the original software project name, which is the Onion Router. It is basically a network of servers that route your internet traffic so that it can protect your identity and location. With the Tor browser, you stay anonymous by connecting to the Tor network. You will then be directed through a network of servers so that your identity and location is secure and protected. The Tor network is designed in such a way that no server can know who you are and what you are doing. The cool thing about Tor is that when you are done with your browsing session, it will automatically delete your cookies, history, and other browsing data. To download the Tor browser, just head over to their download page, which is www.torproject.org/download. When it opens up, it will show you the download options for the different operating systems. I am using Windows, so I'm just going to click on here, download for Windows. And then it will start the download. Once the download is done, we need to verify our download. This video is about you being anonymous online and the bad guys can prey on that. So we need to make sure that what we actually got is the correct and untampered Tor browser download. To verify, just click on this question mark after signature. It will open up a new tab with the steps of how you can verify that you actually downloaded the right Tor browser. If you want to watch me verify, there's a link in the description below of a video that I did doing that, as well as up at the top here. Now let's just close this. And then go to where we downloaded the file and then start the installation process. To start the installation, just double click on our downloaded and verified file. It will ask me for the language. I'm going to keep English selected and click OK. It then gives me the default destination folder. I don't like to install it there because I don't like anything on my desktop. So I'm going to click on browse and then select this PC and then go to my F drive. And I'm just going to select that. So I'm going to install it on F. As you can see, it's going to go on F Tor browser. And then I'm going to click on install to start the installation. When the installation completes, it will give you these two options, which is run Tor browser, as well as add start menu and desktop shortcuts. As I just said, I don't like anything on my desktop. So I'm going to unselect this and then click on finish. This will launch the Tor browser. When this opens up, I'm just going to click on connect. But before that, let me just close this windows and then click on connect. It can take a bit of time. And there you have it. Our Tor browser is running. As you can see, the search engine that the Tor browser uses is DuckDuckGo. DuckDuckGo is an anonymous search engine and it distinguishes itself from other search engines by not profiling its users and by showing all users the same search results for a given search term. To check that you're indeed connected to the Tor network, you can type in check.torproject.org in the Tor browser and we should get a green confirmation message. So I'm just going to paste it. As you can see, we got our green confirmation message. It also showed us our IP address, which is different from our usual IP address. If you try this in Chrome or another browser which is not connected to the Tor network, you'll get a big red not using Tor message. So let me just go to my Chrome and then paste the same URL. And as you can see, we got the message, sorry, you're not using Tor. Top tip, it is recommended that you never maximize your window. This is because it allows websites to identify your monitor size, which can then be used to track you. Be sure to watch to the end of the video for another top tip. Now let's go through some of the options we have on the browser. If you click on the options menu here at the top right hand corner, you see all the options available. In this instance, I'm going to look at new identity. New identity will close all your windows and tabs and restart the Tor browser. It will basically create for you a new identity within Tor. You might want to do this to prevent your previous browser activity being linked to your subsequent browser activity. To demonstrate this, I'm just going to go back here and then search for A. And then open a new tab and then search for Z. After the tabs have opened, you can see here it's A, and then here it's Z. I'm going to come here and click on New Identity. It will ask for a confirmation to close all the windows and tabs, and all the website sessions will be lost. If you want, you can just click Yes. If you don't want to be asked this again, you can check on Never Ask Me Again before you click on Yes. I'm just going to click Yes. And as you can see, my Tor browser restarted. Now, instead of going through the options here and then clicking New Identity, you can just click on this brush icon here. It does the same thing. Now let's move on to the shield icon here, which shows our current security level. As you can see, we are currently at the standard level. There are two other levels which are safer and safest, and you can enable them by clicking here on the advanced security settings. As you can see here, we've got safer and safest. Now let's get into the deep web. So let me just close this and let's search for the deep web news portal, which is the hidden wiki. But before we get deep into it, I just wanted to show you this eye, which is besides our security lock. If you click on it, you see the steps the browser has taken to reach this website. As you can see, it went through three countries, Germany, France, and Romania, to reach this website. This is also why our browsing speed may be slower, because we'll be connecting through a series of servers in different countries. But if you ask me, I think slower browsing speed is a small price to pay for privacy and anonymity. This path here is also known as the circuit for the site you wanted to reach. The guard here is the entry point to the Tor network. If you click on New Circuit, it will just go through a different path to get to our search result on DuckDuckGo. Let me just click here so that you can see changing from Germany, France, Romania to Germany, United Kingdom. Notice here that the guard doesn't change. If you want to change the guard, check out the video I've linked in the description below, as well as up here on how to do that. So from here, let's click on the hiddenwiki.org. And notice that this website we're looking at isn't encrypted, as it is not a .onion site. But from here, we can find a whole host of .onion sites. From here, let me just select the hiddenwiki.onion here. Once it opens up, you can see categories and a lot of .onion sites that you can go to. As you can see, financial services. If I scroll down, you can see blogs and essays. And if I scroll further down, you can see animal related and underage. Just a side note here, the .onion sites form the deep web. The deep web is just a collection of non-indexed pages, which means that you can't find these pages on a search engine. This is different from the dark web. The dark web refers to pages that are both non-indexed as well as involved in illegal niches. Now let me just close this. With Tor, it's extremely important to be always on the latest version. To ensure that, click on the menu options here and then select options. And then you can either scroll down to where it says Tor Browser Updates, or you can just search it here in the search box. Here, make sure that Allow Tor Browser to Automatically Install Updates is selected. You can also click on here, Check for Updates, to check for the updates. As you can see, it says Tor Browser is up to date. And now for the promised top tip. Never install extensions or add-ons on your Tor browser. This is because it can compromise your privacy and security by making your Tor browser fingerprint unique. This can then be used to de-anonymize and track you. This was just a brief on how you can download and use the Tor browser on your computer. In the next videos, I'll show you how to use Tor on mobile, that is both Android and iOS. I will also show you the do's and don'ts of using the Tor browser to keep yourself 100% safe. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to hit like and subscribe.